key? Anybody who doesn't have a
soft-sided, yeah. This is him.
Now you write your room number and you can wear
it. Soft copy, this is him.
You correct in situ wherever you observe. As far as possible, you use the symbol, but that's not credible. To detect the error, you just mark it there. Then you imagine this is in two columns. And roughly whatever is on left, the error you mark on there. You just count the error and write against the line number. And whatever is on right, write on right. If you want to write in one place only, that is your choice. If you can count correctly in the line, you can write in any one place in a column. So in each row you will get the total of errors here. You total them right up to row 34. And write the total in total here. That is the assignment.
How many of you have not brought the sheet containing proof editing symbols with you? You have not brought. So many of you. Some of you seem to be under the impression that the handouts are of ornamental value to be kept in your cupboards. Now those of you who haven't brought the sheet with them, I presume that either you have learned those symbols by heart, which is unlikely in some cases. So I suggest that you look at the neighbor's sheet for the time being. Each one of you has a notebook specifically devoted to this course or not yet? How many of you have a combined notebook in which you take notes for various subjects? Can you raise your hands, please? So how in the month of March you will be able to locate what was discussed in the fourth lecture of a course? You are all computer science students. This simple database indexing. You will have data in that, index wise all corrupted. This happens with human memory. If you enforce it onto paper memory also, it is very unfortunate. So please ensure it's not an extra notebook is not very costly. I don't care what you do for other courses. I would still suggest that thin notebooks but different notebooks for different subjects is a useful idea to follow it from the next time. Which means that whatever notes you have taken for the first two lectures have to be meticulously copied into the notebook. There is no substitute. Or take a Xerox or whatever and pin it, whatever you do. Keep them at hand. All right. So all yours. And next, then you will have to read the text carefully. So now, we have spent so much time in sitting arrangement and announcements, etc. Please do not rush up with your correction. Read the passage very carefully. It's a plain English passage. There are mistakes of the kind that we all make. You have to correct those mistakes using the proof editing symbols and count the errors in each line. He has suggested that you roughly imagine the text to be in two columns, but if you can count all of them and put the number against the line number, that is also okay. Anybody who catches all the errors in the first attempt would deserve a clap by the entire class. In last several years, we did not unfortunately have such an occasion. Let us see if this batch has some bright proof editors. One. How many of you are towards the last half of the lines or less than that? Many. Okay, fine. We'll give another 5 to 7 minutes. This is important, so please do it attentively. Quite a few. Just checking it once again, I suppose. Remaining people, please. I don't want to rush you out, but please do it as quickly as possible. We still have another 3-4 minutes before we start this discussion. Yeah, this is not a discussion assignment. So you have to do it individually. There would be occasions when we'll require you to discuss among yourselves and do that, which of course results in better correction. But right now, it is expected that you attempt individually. We still have 3 more minutes, so those of you who have completed might want to once again read the passage as if you are reading it for the first time and try to see if you have missed out on something. Ideally, we would like to achieve perfection where everybody catches every error. Okay, I guess we'll have to close it. I'll just give you 1 minute. Instead of finding any new errors, those of you who have not written the counts against each line at the bottom, please fill up the count quickly, because that count is going to be entered by the TAs online and will find the class averages and everything immediately, which you will be able to see. So please do the count quickly. I request the TAs after 1 minute to collect all the time. You have to write the count in the bottom table against every line number. Okay, everybody is done? Anybody still counting, please raise your hand. Oh my God. Count doesn't take long, yeah. Okay, I would request TAs to kindly collect all the submissions. You can see why I don't have to depend upon attendance through your fingerprints, etc. What you submit is your attendance. Of course, don't get fancy ideas to submit 2 or 3 sheets simultaneously. All right. All sheets collected? Anybody whose paper has not been collected? Your TA is absconding. Ah, there. Just submit the sheet right now. Discussions later. None of you are doing any innovation in logistics handling. You know what is the fastest way of this collection? All people sitting in a row pass their papers to one end, and the TA just travels in a single line at one end. None of you thought of it, TAs did not think of it. We are trying to optimize time in a classroom where the time of so many people is involved. Every second counts. But what I was noticing is everybody was sitting like a Ganapati till a TA approaches, and then he will consentedly pick up a sheet and give it to me. This is terrible. You have to handle logistics as efficiently as possible. In fact, many of you might actually do entrepreneurial activities based on logistics optimization later. You can't do that unless you optimize it. Anyway, now before I hand over to Professor Prakash Vaidya, I would like to just mention. One question I want to ask you before he begins his explanation. This was just one sheet of text, and you spent exactly 20 minutes correcting it. Agreeably, the proof editing symbols which were new would have consumed some part of your thinking time. But most of it was to identify errors in the text. Now, how many of you in the past have spent 20 minutes on a single page of your writing for any report in your life earlier? I would submit none of you would have. Yeah. You.
Only on the abstract part that I submitted.
Only abstract part.
More than abstract, only the abstract. Because there is something viewable by any people.
Okay. So he is further optimizing his time. He believes that 90% of the people reading his paper will read only the abstract. And therefore, he concentrates on abstract correction, but at least that is good. The point I am making is, this is exactly one very sharp difference between all Indian researchers and professionals and the people from the developed world. They are not brighter. They do not necessarily do better work. They perhaps articulate a bit better, but they spend enormous amount of time in ensuring that there is no error in their written article. Now, if you want to catch up with the world, this is something that you have to imbue in your mind and heart. There is no shortcut. Why I say this is, later on when you submit your seminar and R&D report or any such report, throughout the semester you will be working on it. But you would not set aside 7 full days of working time to correct what you have written. You will not. The report will be written 2 days before the final submission. And it will be so horrible. I do not know how many of you are aware, but in the MTech examinations that we sit to evaluate, typically people who submit lousy reports lose at least 1 grade because of the lousiness in the report. Nobody gives a damn as to how well the work is. If it is not well presented, you lose 1 grade. So this is a practical aspect of life, even in evaluation. And if you lose 1 grade, in the MTech first stage, second stage evaluation because of this, imagine what would you lose in your professional life. People have lost business opportunities because of badly articulated. So now I'll request Prakash to identify this. But please remember one thing, right now plan, whenever you plan to write a report, you will assign, let's say I will take 3 days to write a report. 50% of that time minimum must be additional allocated in your planning to correct whatever you have written. 50% of the time that you take for writing. Minimum. It could be more. And it does not matter whether you use these proof editing symbols or not. It's just reading, correcting errors, which is important.
Okay. Since we are short of time, we'll only analyze the first few lines. And then we'll continue in the next class. But just now, does everybody remember how many errors you had detected yourself? Or somebody doesn't remember?
Most
so we'll just take a
quick stats, how many detected between 0 to 10 errors or 1 to 10?
Please say 0
because somebody might.
Anybody has detected up to 10 errors only?
Please say less than 10.
Less than 10 errors. Everybody has detected more than 10 errors.
Then 11 to 20.
11 to 20. Very large number.
Then 21 to 30.
Another very large number.
Same people are not.
It should be, these are disjoint groups, by the way.
How many?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Okay. 41 onwards, anybody?
1, 2, 3.
Good, so many people have really done well. The actual count is maybe how much? Actual count in here is 50. So you can see many people are close. At 0 to 10, nobody was there.
No.
Nobody was there.
But 11 to 20 and 21 to 30, there were
a lot of people.
So you have to be careful. The will, can we put this up on as a PDF file?
Everything we'll put
on the Moodle. We'll just upload it on the Moodle.
We'll put anonymized data.
Yeah.
So that your
no, it's not anonymized data. What I want you to do is something more. Take the PDF file.
Yeah.
And spend. You would have identified most of the errors, so it will be fresh in your mind. So try to relook at it even after this explanation. Try to relook at the whole sheet and see whether you can identify those errors. It's a good exercise, useful exercise.
Yes. So this, the master will explain next time around so that people who haven't got those errors, they will catch up. Just now I'll just tell you the summary of your assignment well.
Let me do the honor. This summary of your assignment submission is not about errors that you have made in writing. It is about the style of writing and submission. So for example, A4 size was described. 10 people have not submitted their assignments on A4 sheets. Can those 10 friends raise your hands, please? 1, 2, 3, 4. So why is it that you could not locate a A4 size paper? You are careless. Okay. The number of pages, I said one or at most two, but there are some people who have written larger number of pages. That is good because they have more to write. But the point is that in any communication, for that communication to be effective, it should also be as concise as possible without losing the charm of your story. So writing something within one or two pages is also an art, even if you have a longer story to tell. There was a clear-cut instruction that you should write only on one side of the paper. As many as 28 people have written on both sides. Can those 28 friends raise their hands? I think there is something drastically wrong, because either you don't read instructions or you couldn't care less if there are instructions. You will follow your own mind dictation. It's okay. It's a free world. But do not expect to be rewarded in your profession if you follow your free world instinct. There is a certain discipline that is expected in any activity. Either don't participate in that activity, or if you participate, comply with it. I'll tell you another thing. Half the time, I'm a performance expert, I've been a performance expert, and half the time when we noticed a performance problem and went to analyze there, we found out that people had not read either the Oracle database manual or the Linux manual and had not complied with very specific instructions given on what parameters to set for this kind of thing. People don't read and follow.
start time and end time is not mentioned by several people. Duration was not asked, but some people on their own, they have written the duration. But start time and end time was mandatory, not for any information to be sought by me, it is for your own records. Now what it means is, another very, very, what should I say, sad aspect of our societal shortcoming. We do not record things. Our history is written by others. We don't write diaries. We don't write. So record keeping or history maintenance is something that again has to be inculcated in ourselves. There were three things which were not prescribed, deliberate. It was not prescribed that you should leave margin on the left-hand side when you write. Only 7 people have left good margins. Others have not. They have written A4 size means pull from left corner to right corner. Only 7 people have used ruled paper, although it was not prescribed. It is not essential, but you will all agree, having written that one page in handwriting, if you have a ruled paper, your lines don't go diagonally or vertically or something like that. They generally are horizontal. Duration, as you said, mentioned only by 12 people, but that's it. Now, this is not about the quality of writing. This is about the format of writing. And I'll end by saying that, please, I'll repeat what I said earlier, please do not confuse one for the other. Both are important. Both are vital. The quality of writing as well as form of writing. One is not a substitute for other. We'll stop with this. We'll continue. So my TAs have done minimum errors found are 7. Maximum errors found are 55. I would like to know whether we have missed out on 2 errors. Our people were so enthusiastic to find errors, but the average error found is 22.6, and that should be a cause of concern for all of us. Now, this is not something which should be done in isolation by an individual. That is why I will be putting up this on the website. I would suggest that 2 or 3 of you in a group at least spend 10 minutes in discussing only those errors which you have not found, so that you know exactly where your mind missed reading something. All right? And then we'll continue these discussions for 1 more day. Thank you.